And welcome back to Annabelle White, who is filling in again for Mark.
Oh, look at this, panna cotta. Look at that lusciousness. I want you to have an out-of-body experience. Just try that and, I mean, how good is that? And it's so simple.
Oh my God, that is amazing.
Amazing.
Are we going to make that, or are we just going to use it? That's incredible.
Oh, tell you what. It's going to be a great show today. I'll tell you what, panna cotta in about 2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay, good. Well, we might have to talk a bit more because we've got a bit of time to fill. But you can take me through everything and also what's going on with the food show.
I know.
Which
so
is
much
going
excitement.
To be fantastic. Starts on Thursday. Great to have you with us. We're in the Beko kitchen. And Annabelle, thanks again for filling in for Mark. I'm not as good a sous chef as he would be, but... this is really easy to make, isn't it? So we'll be all right.
You're a natural, because at the end of the day, when you're serving delicious food, you've got to have a great, generous spirit, and you've got loads of that.
That's a nice way of saying I can't really cook.
And you know what? The interesting thing is, even if you are a complete reject in the kitchen, you will have success with this.
Okay,
because
great.
Because it is absolutely designed for completely to solve all your problems.
Okay, so we're making panna cotta, and that can traditionally be quite hard, but not with the way Fresh As have done it. We're going to show you how simple it is, and we're going to learn a bit more about Fresh As. So what have we got?
All right, darling, if you turn the hob on.
Okay, I can do that.
I've got 150 mils of cream.
Now yes.
Isn't that beautiful? I love this. Don't you just love this gorgeous
stuff? Is that another one of the Mud Australia products?
Yeah,
good
beautiful.
Work.
And nice. 50 mils of milk. I use the blue top milk with that. Now, here's the thing. We want it to heat it, but we want it to be like we're going to give the baby a bottle.
Okay.
Just lukewarm, darling, lukewarm. So what we're going to do...
like that.
Then we just open up the packet, and as soon as it gets to that lukewarm stage, and the marvellous thing is, don't even want the bubbles on the side, because if you overheat it...
Yes.
And you add the packet mix, it will end up being a little mousse-like.
Okay.
If you just have it lukewarm like the baby's, you know, milk, it'll be just perfect. But
you don't need to
put a thermometer in there. It's not complicated.
Right. Okay,
you just need to have a little look, and you can dink your little finger in there and let me know if it's getting hot.
Okay,
I like
to clean first, you know.
I'll do it. No, it's just a little bit more and we're good to go.
But okay, you know, so that's right. So don't heat it up too much, lukewarm, and you're ready to go.
But if you're going to the Auckland Food Show this week, I want you to check out Tommy, which is at Fresh As, because this is a great story.
Okay, tell me more about Tommy.
Tommy is completely media shy. He's the sort of guy who I've said to him many times, he's created this incredible product, which I'm going to tell you about in a second. Mm. But he's really, I say to him, come on the radio, come on the TV. He goes, oh, no, no, no. You know, he's off doing things like skiing or doing stuff because he doesn't,
he doesn't want
the attention. But I say to him, he's a genius, because what he's done is they freeze dries our lovely New Zealand fresh raspberries and also our herbs and other ingredients. And the essence of that, when they reduce all the liquid out of the fruit, they make it into this incredible powder. Mm. And they made it into this incredibly easy. Well, see, I think that's...
You're happy now?
I sort of am. Yes, I sort of am. Now, they say remove from the heat, but you can just turn it off.
Right?
I add the packet mix. I mean, look how simple is this. They say add it gradually, but we haven't got time to muck around. But here we go. Now, Mike, can you just keep stirring?
What flavour are we doing here?
Oh, we are doing Black Doris Plum, and I'm telling you, it's an out-of-body experience, this stuff. And that is how easy it is. That's how simple it is.
Dessert I can make.
This is brilliant. The thing is, they've got the gelatin that's in the mix, and the great thing about it, Mike, is that in actual fact, it's designed so that within almost you coming off the heat, you will actually find it starts to thicken up. So that within, you could pop this into the freezer and you would have a dessert in maybe a 1 or 2 hours, and
Tommy's done a great job, not only to save us time in the kitchen, but also, you know, understanding where all our food is coming from, because he uses the best ingredients.
And it's just been released into Australia. It's going crazy, and their website's crazy in terms of, if you can't get to the food show, you can get their bits and bobs on their Fresh As website. Now, look, you've done that, and what you do now, here we go, is you get these Dariel moulds. You've got two options. You can either cascade that into a bowl and serve that with just a spoon and people just get in, or you do this. Now, these are Dariel moulds, and they're greased lightly with a bit of neutral oil like canola oil or spray.
What moulds do you call them?
They're called Dariel.
Dariel, okay, cool.
But I'll be honest with you, they create a little bit of anxiety for me. I tend to find life is complicated enough as it is without too much stress, so I tend to, generally speaking, just use them like I served for you earlier. Let me just show you what I'm talking about, Mike. Look at this. You see?
Nice.
I just put them into these lovely, very aesthetic-looking Japanese teacups.
You can use anything, really.
So you can, in actual fact, you don't have to. This, of course, these ideally are going to come out like a panna cotta
and look amazing.
Look like a fancy restaurant. But nice. If you are stressed and this is a little bit too much for you, just go with this.
Brilliant.
No one's going to say, oh, look, I would have come to your party if you'd put it into a dariole mould. If they do,
yeah, that's right,
you just say, put it back on the fridge. But this is a great thing. So if you're going to the Auckland Food Show, please look out Tommy. He feeds everybody this stuff and he's the most extraordinary man and he's got the biggest heart and he honestly is just... I think that's what I love about the Auckland Food Show. You meet these lovely people.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it?
It is a
celebration of food, something
kiwi.
That you definitely want to get along to if you can. Very kiwi, and of course, you're going to meet some fantastic people. And we'll show you a little more of this a little later on. Learn more about the food show. And if you want your tickets, foodshow.co.nz, or you can get them at the door. Annabelle and I are here in the Beko Kitchen. The food show is on in Auckland this week and we are using some of the products from the food show fresh as today.
So good, so delicious, so intensely fruity, so deliciously herby. It's great stuff.
Intensely fruity, I like that. It is beautiful. Do you want me to get them out of the fridge
for you? I think you should. No,
okay,
go ahead,
cool.
Mike. Be useful.
Okay, cool.
Make yourself busy. Now, we're going to just serve a little something with our beautiful panna cotta. They were so simple and easy to make.
Mm-hmm.
We saw that, and we've got two options here, just to clarify, because I want to make sure everyone understands what I'm talking about here. When we made the mix in the pot, we poured it into the dariole moulds, which we've got there in the fridge. These ones have been prepared earlier. They're cool, they're ready to go, and as you see, they're quite firm.
Mm-hmm.
These ones, because I get a bit stressed getting these out on the... Something you don't want to do on national TV.
True.
These ones are my little ramekins and odds and sods that I've got from op shops and
you
things like that.
You just leave them in there, do you?
So you've got a couple of options. So what
yes.
we're going to do...
Okay, this is exciting.
This is going to be very exciting, but before we do this, because I don't want to be stressed out because this may not necessarily work for me.
What is this?
This, my dear, is creme fraiche. Are you ready?
Nice,
now,
yes.
Creme fraiche is the most marvellous, mooly, delicious, rich, cultured cream. Now, to that, are you ready? You've got your clean hands. I want you to break up a few of these meringues with enthusiasm in there. And then what we're going to do is, with fresh airs, I've got these other lovely products, and I'm just going to throw in here as well. They've got these freeze-dried, look at these, freeze-dried raspberries. How good is that? Try one of those,
okay,
darling.
Okay, cool. Oh, I love this show.
Okay, we're just going to crunch these up here.
That is so packed with flavour. That is amazing.
Oh, so good. This is sort of like a winter's version of Eat and Mess. Now, put a bit more meringue in there.
Yeah,
be generous,
cool.
Darling. Be generous.
Am I breaking it up enough?
No, you're fine. You have anxiety when you do desserts. I noticed that with you.
I have anxiety with most
anxiety.
Things I do.
You have to have more confidence. Go for it.
Okay, good. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, go, yeah.
Oh.
That's okay.
Is that what we want?
Yeah. Maybe
enthusiasm.
Not.
Enthusiasm.
And we're adding a bit of strawberry powder just because it's here on hand. Tommy gave us this. This is fantastic. Now, just gently, like Nigella. Think Nigella.
Yes.
Gently just move that all in together.
Okay.
Okay, darling? Move it all in together. I know it's a little pathetic spoon, but that doesn't matter. And then we've got these lovely, beautiful bowls, which we're going to... Are you okay there?
Yeah,
you
I was
good?
Thinking about the little spoon. But you know what,
you
Annabelle?
Know what? It doesn't matter
doesn't
when there's
matter.
You and I together. Now, throw that into there, sweetheart, because that's our serving bowl.
Okay.
And then what we're going to do now is we're going to put the beautiful... Oh, look at that.
I know. You ought to smell it.
Seriously.
It's a shame we don't have smell on TV.
I am telling you, that has got the freeze-dried, the beautiful fresh as whole raspberries broken up. It's got meringue. It's got creme fraiche. And you know what, guys? Here's the good thing. If your company doesn't eat all of this, you can freeze this and it becomes instant ice cream. But we don't need to worry about that. That is delicious. And so now we can take on... Now, look at this one, sweetheart. This is going to be interesting. This is the sort of thing that you would mm-hmm. do in the privacy of your kitchen.
Okay.
You have oiled these.
Yeah.
And they should, in actual fact, you get a white plate. Everything looks better on a white plate.
Good
sometimes,
luck.
Sometimes I recline on a white plate myself. Now, what you do is you should warm this up.
I love this.
And...
Oh, show off.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Now, at this stage, if you've got very, very fussy company, what they do is they come up and they go, does it wobble? And I say to you, if you have visitors who come home and ask you if your panna cotta wobbles, don't even have them back. It's not a good idea. It's ridiculous. Now, what we can do...
Mm.
It's just to zhuzh this up a little bit.
Yes.
I think we can. I quite like the way you're breaking things up here, sweetheart.
Okay, good.
Would you like to just break a few of these in your hands?
Yes.
And I'm just going to get a little bit of syrup, which I'm just going to plonk on here, or you could put just a little bit of syrup just to give a little bit of that kind of Jamie Oliver vibe around the plate. But you're going to put some of those on top of there, like so. Oh, come on, darling, come on. Honestly, true.
Oh, look at that.
It's not the perfect panna cotta. panna cotta, but it looks delicious.
Doesn't
and
it?
And the thing is, if you sit and put some more on there, darling.
Oh, yeah, cool. Yep, sprinkle,
but
sprinkle,
but generous,
sprinkle.
Darling, generous,
okay,
generous.
Good.
It's good
you
for
go.
Your digestion. Think of your bowels.
Beautiful.
Okay, now look at this. I have just got to
that
show you.
Amazing.
This is so easy. You saw how quickly we made that. Mm-hmm. Were you even more than a minute stirring that together? I think if you are a little bit anxious about serving these things, you can always go with this option.
Right.
Which is just, you don't have to go through that anxiety and put that there. No one's going to complain. You can even put it into a little glass. But the thing about it, it is just... Oh. Stunning flavour.
It is stunning.
So good.
You have done so well today.
Would you like that? I'll have my little spoon.
Oh,
there,
yeah, cool.
There,
here now, we go. Yeah.
I don't know whether you want to dig. Do you want to dig into
it? I'm going to dig into it a little bit.
Oh, I'll tell you what. Out of body experience, my friend.
Mm.
Unbelievably intense.
Absolutely
so good.
Unbelievable. Now, the Auckland Food Show starts this Thursday at the ASB Showgrounds, where you can go and see the Fresh As team and check out all their fabulous range. Everything from exotic cuisines and artisan eats. So. For the details, go to the website foodshow.co.nz. Annabelle, how's it turned out?
I tell you what, I'm just adding a little bit of extra fruit for you.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I tell you what, and I've got spoons.
Oh, good. I ate some before, so we need to give some to Mel this
time.
Yeah,
look at this. I mean, the thing that's so amazing, look, excuse my dirty fingers.
Yes.
But it was just so simple. Mm. And with that Fresh As lovely freeze-dried, beautiful raspberries on top there, you're going to have the most sensational full fruit flavour. It's so delicious. It's so easy, and it's something that celebrates New Zealand. It's what the Auckland Food Show is all about.
And speaking of the Auckland Food Show, if you're going to be heading along, where can people catch you?
Oh, 10:30.
Yes.
On Thursday and Friday. Come early and wear loose clothing.
Oh, nice. Can I try this?
Yeah, get in there. Sure. No, get in there.
And I've got to tell you that the winter Eton mess with the creme fraiche meringues, and because Mike's so generous with the filling and even the strawberry powder, that's absolutely delicious.
Isn't
so,
it?
And it's just yum.
And if you want to find out more information about the Auckland Food Show, it's at their website, foodshow.co.nz.